So now we are going to study about origin of Indus civilization. Or Harappan civilization. So basically there are two types of approach regarding origin of Harappan civilization or Indus civilization. First is sudden origin theory or foreign origin theory. So basically this theory proposed by D.H. Gordon and Mortimer Wheeler. So basically they were foreigner, right? And they tried to interpret the origin of Indus civilization according to imperialistic view of history. Imperialistic view of history. For the understanding of that approach, we have to understand some background of this approach. Basically, when Britishers come to India and occupied India, then they propose that Indian culture is started in Vedic period. That Arjan culture was developed in India by foreigner Arjan, because Arjan come to India from Middle Asia. And basically when Arjan at first come to Iran from Middle Asia, then they were divided into two part. One group come to India and another group went to Europe. So basically Englishman proposed that culture developed in India by Arjan. Arjan were foreigner, but the people belongs from upper class, upper caste of India. They are the descendant of Arjan. And English people are also descendant of Arjan. Right? So we are not foreigner. They propose that basically there are close relationship between the Arjan people of India and Britishers, because both belongs from common ancestor and both have common culture. So basically our history is started from Vedic culture, and they tried to explain Vedic culture was the product of foreigner Arjan. And people who belongs in India, basically from upper caste, they are Aryan. And English people are also descendant of Aryan. This is the approach. And there are continuity of coming of foreigner people in India. And when foreigner come to India, they are doing very good job for the development of culture in India. But when there was discovery of urban civilization in 1921 from Harappa, so basically before that they interpret that Arjan culture or Vedic culture was the development of Arjan people who belongs from Middle Asia, right? Ancestor of Arjan. So they are facing problem now, how we interpret about the origin of that civilization. So they interpret origin of Indus civilization according to empirical view. Empirical view is that they again interpret that origin of Indus civilization due to foreign influence. And they said that at first urban civilization developed in Mesopotamia, right? And Indus civilization evolved in India due to influence of Mesopotamian people or Mesopotamian civilization or Sumerian civilization. Because that was the product of colonialization of Indus region by Sumerian people. And that Sumerian people are also descendant of Aryan. Right? So basically they tried to interpret about Indus civilization developed by foreigner or foreign influence. And it is developed due to the process of colonialization of this region. Colonialization. And through that they also try to show that colonialization is not a bad thing for India. India has very big experience about the colonialization of Indian society and culture from ancient to present day. So on that basis, they try to explain Indus civilization evolved in India due to foreign influence, and there was no gradual evidence of the development of Indus civilization in this region. Right? They said that because urban civilization developed by Mesopotamian people, Sumerian people, so they introduced that technology which developed in Sumeria, and they developed this urban culture suddenly, very rapidly in this region. So that culture was developed due to foreign influence. And they show some evidence, they give some evidence in the favor of their argument. And they said that there are some similarity between Sumerian civilization and Indus civilization. So first, you have to remember about this thought, this ideology. And they said that both are urban civilization, both have written script, both are a copper bronze age civilization, both people utilize burnt brick for making their house, right? Both utilize seal and ceiling. Both have trade relationship, economic relationship. Therefore, that civilization developed by Sumerian people or the influence of Sumerian people. But after that, there are many Indian scholar as well as foreigner criticize about that approach, and they said that there are fundamental differences between Sumerian civilization and Indus civilization. Because when we study about the urbanization of Indus civilization, we found that Indus urban center was developed on the basis of planned urbanization. We got evidence about planned urbanization from Indus civilization, while Sumerian urban center was unplanned. Their urban center was not planned, right? both have written script, but both have fundamental differences on the basis of the written script. Because Sumerian written script is calligraphy, based on calligraphy, and Harappan written script is based on pictography. It was pictograph. Third important thing is that both are Bronze Age civilization. But Sumerian people utilize more weapon than instrument which was made by bronze, while Harappan people made more instrument than weapon. There was differences in their drainage system, differences in their road, differences in their housing pattern, differences in their pottery, differences in their seal and ceiling. So basically, both civilizations have fundamental differences. And on the basis of that, they propose that there was gradual cultural development in Indus region by indigenous people through development of their own technological advancement. So Indus civilization originated by indigenous people through gradual culture development. So it was the product of gradual culture development. So for the understanding of gradual culture development, we have to study some important phase of culture development: pre-Harappan, early Harappan, and matured Harappan. Right? That developed in 6000 to 3500 BC. That developed between 3500 to 2600 BC. And that developed in 2600 BC to 1800 BC, which we already studied in Chalcolithic culture, right? When we have studied about Chalcolithic culture, we study that thing. So on the basis of that, we try to explain Indus civilization was the product of gradual culture development. Because in this period, there was some important development in Mehrgarh. Mehrgarh and Qila Gul Mohammad. Right? What happened after Neolithic culture in Mehrgarh and Qila Gul Mohammad? We already discussed it. Right? There was development of Chalcolithic culture. And therefore, there was utilization of copper tools in agriculture. There was more surplus production in Mehrgarh and Qila Gul Mohammad. There was development of short distance trade. The size of village is increased than Neolithic people. They started utilization of clay for making their houses. So first important thing happened here in that phase that gave us information about how there was development of Chalcolithic culture, which was advanced than Neolithic culture. Right? Second, in that era, Kalibanga. Are you hear the name of Kalibanga? Kalibanga or Kalibangan, you can also wrote Kalibangan. This is situated in Rajasthan, Ganganagar district of Rajasthan, in Ghaggar Hakra Basin. So when you are going to study Indus civilization, you have to remember about two important things. We got evidence from Kalibanga from early Harappan phase as well as matured Harappan phase. Are you clear about that or not? Always remember that in archaeology, I already said that we excavate archaeological site in stratigraphic method. So here I am talking about that. Suppose this was the early Harappan phase and that was the matured Harappan phase. Right? So basically from Kalibanga, we got both two phases. राइट बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट यहाँ से जो फाइंडिंग है जूते हुए खेत का साक्ष्य है ना. वेयर वी गॉट दिस फेस और दिस फेस जब आपने जीएस में पढ़ा होगा कालीबंगा से जुता हुआ खेत का साक्ष्य मिला है. एविडेंस अबाउट प्लॉ बेस्ट फिल. सो हियर वी गॉट दैट एविडेंस फ्रॉम दिस फेस एंड दैट एविडेंस गिव अस इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट दैट their agriculture technology is advanced because they were capable to produce more than two grain in one field in one season. More than two grain, two or more than two grain in one field in one season. So their agriculture technology was advanced. So here, when we are talking about agriculture technologies advanced, means they are capable to produce more surplus production than pre-Harappan stage of culture. Right? They were capable to produce more surplus production than pre-Harappan stage of culture development. Second important thing is that Amri that was situated in Sindh province of Pakistan. Sindh province of Pakistan. So we got granary from Amri in this that stage. So granary gave us insight about that really there was more surplus production in that stage of cultural development. Right? Really, there was more surplus production in that stage of culture development. And third important site is Kodiji. Kodiji, where we got about the fortification, evidence about fortification by backed brick. And fortification is the earliest cultural process for urbanization. It gives us about the sign of the process of urbanization. Right? We also got a special type of pottery from Kota Diji, which is similar to the pottery we found from Mesut Harpat civilization. Right? Red ware, and which on there was painting by black color. An important site, Mundigang, that we found from Afghanistan. There are two important sites we found from Afghanistan related to Harappan civilization. One is Mundigang and another is Shuturghuy. Shuturghuy. So from Mundigang we got about public building. Evidence about public building. Evidence about public building. Right? Archaeologists interpret that was the center which developed due to trade relationship between people from this region, Indus region, and Middle Asia. Right? So that gives us evidence about continuous cultural development in this region through the development of their own technology. They were not dependent on foreigner. Right? So we found some important feature related to Mesut Harappan civilization, like urbanization, public building, granary, surplus production, long distance trade, that was not sudden development. That was the product of gradual development of culture. Right? So it may be possible there was trade relationship between people of Sumeria, and some element come from Sumeria. But that civilization is fundamentally indigenous. That developed by indigenous people through the development of indigenous technology. So we can say that it was the product of gradual culture development. Right? This is the origin of Harappa civilization.